Jackson, a.k.a. Shane Lee, y'all, is the 31-year-old YouTuber who currently has over 23 million subscribers on his main channel. He also has 8.43 million on Shane Dawson TV and a little over 2 million on his channel, Shane Clawson. Now, since Shane Dawson started his YouTube channel back in 2008, he has released 2 New York Times best-selling books, appeared in several short films, was in the High Fructose Adventure of Annoying Orange, of fucking course. He is a fucking great actor, because he's in the fucking Annoying Orange fucking TV show. But moving on, he has also started his very own makeup line and has had a music career. Because apparently any YouTuber can have a fucking music career besides for me. KSI has, Deji has, Keemstar has even released music. Fucking PewDiePie and iDubbbz have released songs and I have not. And I'm pretty fucking pissed. But getting back to fucking Shane, he has also produced, directed, and of course starred in his very own film called Not Cool, which grossed $36,000. This would be cool if the budget was not $800,000. Way to go, Shane! I totally do not understand why you have not released more movies. And before you fucking get up my ass saying that we do not have movies of our own so we can't say shit, well, you can all suck a dick because we have had multiple movies and all of them, like, blow out at the fucking Clowny Awards, so you can all suck a dick, you assholes. Once again, getting back to fucking Shane Dawson, who this video is about, not me or my problems. He is known for being one of the originals of YouTube and calling for his conspiracy videos and his documentary series. Moving on to the controversies, he has, oddly enough, been criticized for his comments and jokes on pedophilia, including calling it a fetish, defending it, calling a 6-year-old sexy, and saying he looked up naked babies on fucking Google. This is not fucking classified as edgy jokes. This is just fucked up. He is also acting as if it's true. Why would you want to act like that's true? Like you actually looked up naked fucking babies. Who would claim this is true? This is weird. It's not funny either. Of course, though, when criticized for it, he made several excuses, including saying that people were out to get him and saying, making these weird fucking shock value jokes was a character he played out of insecurity, and also adding that everything was taken out of context. Newsflash, that makes no fucking sense, Shane. Making jokes while pretending to still be yourself is not a character. You're just yourself making edgy jokes. It's weird to say it was a character, and it's weirder that making jokes about looking up naked babies and defending pedophilia is what you do out of being insecure. Most people put on like a hoodie or something, and you're just making edgy, weird jokes about naked babies. It's also not really that much out of context. You did indeed say these things. It's also very hard to take it out of context when you basically said a whole paragraph about it. It's not like they just took one line and like putting it in their own words and spinning it on you. You did indeed claim you were like the biggest babies on Google for some reason. Moving on though, because apparently this video can't be fucked up enough and cannot be any more quickly taken down by YouTube, which is kind of the goal at this point. I hope this thing gets fucking taken down. We are moving from pedophilia to racism. Because before he did makeup, he was doing blackface in several videos, including pretending to be Nicki Minaj, which he really didn't need to do the blackface for. He could have just worn the clothes, the wig, and the eyelashes like he did in the video. He didn't need the blackface to signify that he was Nicki Minaj. He has also used the N-word on multiple occasions in videos, like saying it was the word of the day. And in another video, he called a black woman the N-word and a monkey woman. Fucking KSI said it was like a lot of bad choices. And you know, it's fucking bad when KSI is fucking criticizing you. He's not a good person here, and he is saying you're shit. That must mean you are really shitty. Now I know some of you may defend this, saying there was a lot of just shock humor. It was jokes. It was a long time ago and all that bullshit. And he did indeed crappily apologize for these things. But let me just counter-argue you that right now for you. It is still shitty to fucking do. And I am getting tired of this defense that it was shock humor and it's not who he is anymore. And it was a long time ago. He still did them. You can't just walk up and shoot somebody and commit a hate crime and then 10 years later be like, oh, come on. Don't get up my ass for it. Oh, come on. Don't get up my ass because I said I looked up naked babies. It was shock humor. Fuck you. You still did it. Moving on, though, to the next controversy, which came after one of his conspiracy videos was aimed at Chuck E. Cheese. In said video, he claimed that the business reused the pizza slices that nobody ate to make new pizzas. This, of course, caused a lot of negative publicity for the business and also caused others to test out the theory and so forth, which continued to spread this rumor around and negatively affect the business. And I know some people may say that this is not a big deal, but it's pretty bad when a multi-million dollar corporation like Chuck E. Cheese responds to a YouTuber. They obviously were indeed being impacted by this rumor. And he also has a pretty big audience, so it's probably best to watch what he says at times, especially when he really didn't do much research into this. He didn't, like, meet with the CEO of Chuck E. Cheese. He really just, like, bought a pizza and saw if it lined up or not. Though this leads to our next controversy, which is a pretty common one that has came up over the years from his conspiracy theory videos, which many people say spreads misinformation to his young audience, which, as we previously said, comprises of 23 million people. Even if half of those people believed what he said, whether he intended them to believe it or not, just imagine that all these kids are also going around and spreading this misinformation, which has been on subjects from 9/11 being a hoax to the moon landing being fake and other subjects. I know that many people follow conspiracy theory videos. But when you have the audience that he has, you have to have a little responsibility in how you deliver the information. A lot of the conspiracy theory videos on YouTube are joke videos like how KFC is the Illuminati or some bullshit like that. He really needs to watch how he delivers this information, especially when it's actually against the YouTube guidelines, whether you agree with them or not, to spread misinformation, especially about historic events. So it's pretty odd when you think about it that other channels can get in trouble for this, but Shane Dawson can do it all he fucking wants. Now moving back to the weirdness of Shane Dawson, we could not, of course, do this video without bringing up a clip from his podcast that blew up the internet not too long ago. You see, a weird clip resurfaced where he claimed he engaged in sexual activities with his damn cat. Of course, after he was criticized a little bit and he became the joke of the internet for the day, he denied these rumors that he actually did it, and of course stated it was just another edgy joke. He seemed pretty annoyed by the situation overall, which is pretty ironic, I guess, because he probably doesn't like when people spread misinformation about him. Don't you, Shane? You don't like misinformation spread about you? I guess if I say it as a conspiracy theory, can I say it then? Is misinformation only allowed to be delivered as a conspiracy theory video? Or is it only okay when you do it? Let's move on, though, from his conspiracy theory videos to his documentary series videos. Firstly, The Mind of Jake Paul series, which was released not too long ago. In said series, he posed the question of if and could Jake Paul be a sociopath. This, of course, angered a lot of people and even drew mainstream attention. Many saw this video as misinformative and insensitive. He also, in this video series, this part especially, put in clips of other YouTubers and such, which, intentionally or not, implied them also to be sociopaths. He also very broadly and cleverly explained sociopath to the degree that it could apply to basically anyone, which, yet again, with his young audience, continues his streak of delivering misinformation. His docu-series on Jeffree Star also has came under fire after people were frustrated when it didn't deliver on what it promised. It was not only cut short, but also a lot of the drama that was promised in the series was cut. Many people criticized it for being kind of clickbait to sell his palette. Overall, his fans felt very lied to. He also pushed off the finale of said series for a variety of reasons, which continued to anger his fans. Now, for a final thing in this video, let's talk about this palette a little bit. His palette grew a lot of criticism when people finally got this much-awaited palette, which cost a pretty penny, if you ask me. I don't know really how much makeup should cost, but this one was on the pricey side. Only for when people finally received it, for the makeup to be cracked and crushed, and there's even hairs in some people's makeup. Well, that's all we have for the video today. Overall, to sum up, well, we did paint Shane Dawson in a pretty bad light. He is not the worst. Santa's why he's a shitty person. Still though, not the worst. I do also want to add in that while he's done a lot of bad stuff, he has apologized for most of it. Whether or not he's good at apologies is another question. As long as he continues to apologize and continues his streak of changing up his content from all this racist and pedophile jokes and all of the other weird edgy jokes he's made to what he's doing now, I think he's on a good path. I also gotta compliment the dude for lasting on YouTube for so long. It's probably has not been easy for him to do. Especially to have the amount of subscribers he has today. Overall though, you still have a lot to work out, Shane. Continue to apologize. Get better at apologizing. But that is all for the video today. I have been Do! Make sure to follow me and Crazy Clowns on Instagram and have a good night! And you know what, at this point, if I just say I have an album coming out, Boardman and the rest of Crazy Clowns probably will be obligated to complete it. So, guess what? New album dropping in the future. Get on it, assholes.